The Pac-Man ghosts guide a little yellow circle around a maze, eating dots and avoiding ghosts in this exciting action-packed arcade game from Namco. Pac-Man took the arcade game world by storm. Not only was it loud and colorful, but the Japanese creators knew exactly what their Western audience was like, so they changed the name of the game from Pac-Man to Pac-Man because they were worried the cabinets would be defaced. You know, by changing the P to an F. That is literally how we got the name Pac-Man. It was a massive commercial success. Simply huge. It had many flow-on effects in popular culture, from animated TV shows, spin-off games, and sequels, but nothing quite beats the original. You're a yellow blob. Your job is to clear the dots out of the maze. If a ghost touches you, you lose one of your three lives. It's the ghosts that are unique, in that they actually had simple AI personalities. This doesn't make them the first computer AI baddies, but it does make them one of the earliest commercial successes. The personalities were as follows: Blinky, red, gives direct chase to Pac-Man; Pinky, pink; and Inky, cyan, try to position themselves in front of Pac-Man, usually by cornering him; and Clyde, orange, will switch between chasing Pac-Man and fleeing from him. Okay, so there's no danger of Skynet spawning from the AI coding in Pac-Man, which, let's face it, is incredibly primitive by today's standards, but it was a lot for 1980. Terminator would have been a very different movie if Arnie had been more interested in eating dots than killing Sarah Connor. The upshot of all of this was that you had a game which played differently almost every time, and this, along with gaudy colors and strident music, almost certainly added to its wide appeal. Pac-Man as a game was not a unique concept. The eponymous character was said to have been based on the image of a pizza with a slice missing, but the creator, Toru Iwatani, has said that Pac-Man was also based on him rounding out and simplifying the Japanese character, Kuchi, meaning the mouth. The dot gathering was based on a similar mechanic in the game Head-On. Sega, 1979. And the power-up Super Dot that allowed Pac-Man to eat the ghosts came from Popeye the Sailor Man, and his temporary acquisition of superpowers upon eating a can of spinach. The ghosts, however, were designed to be baddies without being menacing. They had to appeal to all ages and genders, and be a threat in a traditionally non-violent manner. Initially, the bigwigs at Namco wanted the ghosts to all be a uniform red color, and Iwatani had to fight to give them unique characteristics. He must have got something right, because as of 2016, some 36 years after it was developed, Pac-Man had earned over $14 billion in revenue.